with your thyroid on peripheral convergence. Peripheral convergence normally is expressed on peripheral side. So normally in peripheral tissue like kidney, liver, these are the peripheral tissue which will be responsible for the conversion of T3 into T4. So near about one third T4 is converted into T3. Peripheral side पर क्या होता है आपका near about one third जो T3 T4 होता है वो convert हो जाता है T4 में और जो conversion के लिए responsible tissues होते हैं that is liver and kidney this thing is responsible for peripheral conversion T3 to T4 को convert करते हैं T3. Point of this thing is transport metabolism and excretion of thyroid hormone transportation normally. This thyroid hormone is actively bind with your plasma protein. So, thyroid hormone होता है जो actively आपके plasma protein से bind होता है. Plasma protein का acid is 0.03 to 0.08% bind T4 with plasma protein. और 0.2 to 0.5% is T3. In this way, these two proteins binding with our plasma protein. Plasma protein से इस तरह से bind होते हैं. T3 type of protein is there. 3 protein होते हैं plasma protein जिससे आपका T3 और T4 bind होते हैं. Thyroxine globin. Next one होता है thyroxine binding prealbumin और last one is albumin. These are the 3 type of plasma protein through which your thyroid hormone is bind. Normally जो thyroid hormone bind होते हैं ये 3 hormone से bind होते हैं. Thyroxine globin, thyroxine binding prealbumin और albumin. Now next important thing, this thing is metabolism. How metabolism is taking place of your thyroid hormone? Normally metabolism is by the deiodination reaction of tea or take the gluconate conjugation or sulfate conjugation in your intestine. Or it will be reabsorbed. It shows intrahepatic circulation and finally it will be excreted from your vaginal system. Your kidney say excretion of that. Deiodination मतलब metabolism कैसे होता है deiodination reaction होता है या फिर gluconate या sulfate conjugation reaction होता है due to this actually this reaction takes place in your intestine conjugation and reabsorbed from your intestine it show intrahepatic circulation and finally excreted from the urine. If you see the half life of T4 half life is near about 6 to 7 days or T3 half life near about 1 to 2 days. This is the half life of this T3 and T4. Now next point related to thyroid hormone is regulation of secretion. How regulation of secretion takes place? Is secretion regulated? Okay? So normally what will happen? Secretion for the secretion of thyroid T3 and T4 when hypothalamus is stimulated. Hypothalamus is releasing thyroid releasing hormone TRH. Hypothalamus क्या करता है आपका? TRH release करता है and hypothalamus act on your anterior part of your pituitary. It will stimulate your anterior part of your pituitary gland or anterior part of pituitary gland releases TSH thyroid stimulating hormone. This thyroid stimulating hormone normally stimulate your thyroid gland and T3-T4 is released. Synthesis of release is there. Patient में normally क्या होता है? Hypothalamus stimulate होता है, hypothalamus release करता है thyroid releasing hormone. ये thyroid releasing hormone it will work on. वर्क करता है आपके पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड में इंटीरियर पार्ट ऑफ द पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड सो इंटीरियर पार्ट ऑफ पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड रिलीजेस टीएसए थायरॉइड स्टिमुलेटिंग हार्मोन दिस थायरॉइड स्टिमुलेटिंग हार्मोन वर्क ऑन योर थायरॉइड ग्लैंड और इट विल स्टिमुलेट योर थायरॉइड ग्लैंड एंड T3 T4 इज रिलीज एक्सेसिव अमाउंट ऑफ T3 और T4 विल सप्रेस योर हाइपोथैलेमस तो नॉट टीएचए अगर बहुत ही ज्यादा क्वांटिटी में एक्सेसिव क्वांटिटी में रिलीज हो रहा है तो किसको सप्रेस करता है आपके हाइपोथैलेमस में ये नेगेटिव इफेक्ट करता है this in this way positive or in this way negative feedback mechanism कैसा है कि अगर excessive amount में T3-T4 release होता है वो suppress करता है आपके hypothalamus में तो आपका TRH नहीं release होता तो in this way releases takes place hypothalamus releases TRH thyroid releasing hormone which will work on your anterior part of pituitary gland stimulate होता है TSH release करता है TSH work करता है stimulate करता है आपके thyroid gland को और in this way T3 and T4 is released.